Hey folks, Sirdar here, and in this episode of Dev with Sirdar, I'm going to take a look at Winget. This is the package manager for Microsoft Windows, created by Microsoft itself. See, in the Linux world, package managers are a way to catalog and install the software that's available for the system in a repository. And there is a slew of different package management solutions across the world of Linux distributions, and each one has their own style and preference. In the Windows world, you didn't really have anything like package managers historically. What Winget gives you is several things. First, it gives you an open source directory of Windows software, which you can contribute to through GitHub. If you have a package that you want to host there, you just submit a pull request. It also gives you a command line mechanism for managing packages from Microsoft's repository, or from your own private repository, or from any number of other repositories. And third, it gives you mechanisms for automating the processes of looking for packages, downloading them, updating them, and removing them, so you can fetch and install and manage software for Windows machines in the scriptable and reproducible way. So let's take a look at Winget in action. Now, if you're already running Windows 11, Winget is probably already installed, so all you need to do is type Winget from the command line, and you will see its commands in the terminal. The most common first thing you're going to want to do with Winget is find out if a given package you want to install is available. So you can search for it by name. And Winget search plus a keyword will do the trick. So as you can see, if we type Winget search Python, we're going to generate a lot of hits with it. And some of what's been brought up here are actual editions of the Python runtime. Other things are just programs that are associated with or which use Python. Python is just a keyword here. Now, if I want to install something listed in the repository, the best thing to do is to use the name that is listed for it under the ID column. This allows each one of these packages to be referred to distinctly. And it also allows for us to install and track multiple versions of a given thing. So I can find and install the exact version that I want. And as you can see with Python, this is quite necessary since we have various versions of Python listed all the way back to version 3.0. And I can access them by way of the ID tags that are shown here. I should also note that some of the Python editions that are listed here are the ones that are available through the Microsoft Store. The ones with these tags, these are the actual Python Software Foundation editions. These are the ones you typically want to work with. And then likewise, if I want to search for node.js, I can see the current release version of node.js, which is 20.6.0. And they also have listed the long-term support release, which is 18.17.1. So to install the appropriate one, I would use the label for it in the ID column, openjs.node.js for the current one, and openjs.nodejs.lts for long-term support. So to install Python 3.10, I would type winget install python.python.3.10, and it would begin the install process for that version. I should note that Winget is not responsible for doing the actual installation. It just fetches a package that it has listed in its repository and starts that package's installer. All it's doing is obtaining the redistributable that somebody else provides and triggering that redistributable's install process. Another thing to point out is that the install processes for packages that come through Winget are typically non-interactive. This is good in the sense that you don't have to do anything to make it work. But it's also important to know this if you want to do things like manage the way that a particular package is installed. It's the app installer's responsibility to provide a way to install silently or to provide options. So if you want to modify the default behaviors for an installer when you're installing it through Winget, you can use the --custom flag to pass command line options to the installer to do that. Now, if I do Winget list, I'm going to get a manifest of all the software that's currently installed and tracked through my system in Winget. And you'll notice I have a couple of apps here that have a possible upgrade available. And if I wanted to upgrade them, I could use Winget upgrade and then the ID for the application, or I could just type winget upgrade --all to go through each one of the things that has an upgrade and perform the upgrade. One really useful feature with Winget is that you can also ensure that a specific version of something is not changed. So if you need a specific version of something or you want to do upgrades for that specific thing outside of Winget, you can use a feature called pinning. You can pin a given package to a given version or to a given range of versions, so you can ensure that it only gets upgraded to a specific point or doesn't even get upgraded at all. For instance, this one here that I had the upgrade for, the ASIO for all driver, I don't actually want to have that upgraded through Winget for a whole bunch of reasons I won't go into. It's tied to a whole bunch of other packages that have this have their own separate maintenance process. I want to keep this current version indefinitely, and I want to do upgrades for it totally outside of Winget. So what I can use is the command winget pin add ASIO for all, and that will ensure that this version of that program remains untouched. Another thing that you can do with Winget is use the winget export and winget import commands to dump out and load JSON format manifests of all the packages that you have installed. This is a very convenient way to do batch installs. You can don't have to manually script each winget command, but you can just dump out a JSON file which you can edit to describe which packages to install, and then give that to somebody else with a copy of winget, and they can import it and have those installs performed automatically. One last thing that I want to show is an example of how Winget is a technology that other people can build on. So what we have here is a third-party, non-Microsoft program called Winget UI. It's this very nice UI that we have that sits atop not only Winget, but can also work with other package managers for Windows, like Chocolaty. It can also work with pip for Python. It can work for npm for node.js. But primarily, I'm using it here to show off the way it works with Winget. I can search for packages from various repositories, which I can configure. I can update existing packages if we have any updates available. And I can change or remove what's already installed. So using the command line for Winget is more direct, and I know that many people prefer using the command line to get the exact granular level of control they like, but it's nice to know that you don't have to use only that to work with Winget. So to sum up, Winget is not the only Windows package management solution, but it is the most official one of the bunch, as it is under Microsoft's stewardship. And you can use it to install or update many common applications for Windows, especially dev-related packages. And you can use it to automate installs for reproducible setups. And finally, other tools can be built on top of Winget, such as UIs, for convenience. And that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below. And don't forget to follow Dev with Sirdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com. We'll be right back.